What is the craziest memory leak that I found in C# code? Couple of years back, I was called to look into a .NET leak. So what the file was doing, it was loading XML files. XML files were being read by .NET code. They were being serialized and it was also using some XML document to do some manipulation on the XML, and then it was dumping the XML document in the database. So I started looking into XML document. My first culprit, I thought maybe a XML document is a culprit. Before that, I started doing some memory profiler. I was hoping that I would get lucky and I will find that initial couple of years the XML profiler were not that advanced. So I was hoping I will find some memory leaks using these profilers. Unfortunately, I couldn't get anything. We'll come to know why memory profilers were not able to catch the memory leak. Then I started looking at the XML document and Googling the XML document for memory leaks. And I found something interesting about XML serializer and the memory leaks. Here is a Microsoft document. Basically, it's saying if you create several XML serializer objects in the ESP.NET, the memory usage will go very, very high, especially if you use this signature. If you use this particular signature, the memory leaks will happen. So this is very interesting, is why this particular signature means in the resolutions, it tells you to use this signature with one parameter, signature with two parameter are fine, or signature. What is the problem with this particular signature? So what happens when you call this XML serializer, it's generating a assembly with XML reader and writer class. So for this particular type, if you're writing in a loop, you are reading 1,000 documents, it's going to create 1,000 assemblies. And these assemblies remains in the same app domain. So unless the process killed, the memory won't be released. And the memory, if you're profiling the memory, it will not catch it. How you can catch this problem is, you have to use the performance counters, and in performance counters you have to see the assemblies. If the number of assemblies is increasing, number like 1,000, 2,000, 10,000, that means you have a problem of memory leak. So here he gives example. This is the finally we used. Actually not this one, we used the last one where we declared XML serializer as a static type and used that object over and over. So that way only one assembly generated. You can create the XML serializer and cache it. And don't use this particular signature, use other signature. There's another document by Tess which goes into the details how to generate it. It gives the details that this document basically is creating an assembly and it's generating an assembly. So every time code runs, it creates a new assembly. And assembly is not object which garbage collector can clear. Garbage collector is really unaware of assemblies. So these assemblies won't be garbage collected at all. You have to unload the app domain. So to summarize, this was one of the craziest memory leak I found in one of our code. The solution is not to use this particular signature. If you're using this signature, either generate the instance only once and cache it, are declared as static variable and use it initialize only once and use it again and again, or don't use this signature, use this signature.
Thanks for watching this video. My name is Vikas Kearney. I have more than 20 years of experience in IT industry. I am TOGAF certified architect. Do subscribe to my channel for your regular updates.